Hi everybody, this is Chess from Retro Nirvana Gaming. Welcome. Today we're doing an awesome Nintendo NES collection video where we're going to show you all of our awesome games, the ones in the box, the loose ones. We're going to go over the box consoles that we have here on the channel and a lot of other cool things that are all just NES. Alright, so I hope you enjoy this video. Do me a favor and hit that subscribe button down below when you get a chance. It helps the channel grow. We are so close to 1,000 subscribers at this point. And if you guys would help me with that, that would be fantastic. You'll also see more videos from us. And of course, you're helping the channel grow. Thank you so much. Okay, let's start off with the box games. Now, this collection took quite a while to accumulate all these games. I mean, I started collecting about 12 years ago. And a lot of these were not boxed at the time. So we have, of course, Super Mario Bros. 3, the most classic of all NES games. And very happy to have this boxed one. Looks super awesome, and I'm super happy to have that one. Next comes my favorite game of all time on the NES, is Mega Man 2. So we have a really nice box, but otherwise we have just a little bit of sticker on there for $2.99. So this was looks like a video store copy, and still looks good, presents really well, and I'm happy to have it in the collection since it is my favorite NES game. Next we have Mega Man 3, another really awesome title. This one I got as an upgrade, and box looks really nice. It's a really cool game in general. I love the Mega Man series of games on the NES. We have a very recent addition to the collection, which is Super Mario Bros. The original in the box looks great. Got this at Too Many Game. Actually, no, Retro World Expo. I got this just a few weeks ago, actually, and very happy to have picked this box up. I think I paid about $25 for that, and happy I did because now I have Mario Bros. 1 in the box. Next is Dr. Mario, another classic puzzle game on the NES. As you can see, a lot of the games I collect are actually games that are very popular titles because I'm not really into like the niche ones on the NES. A lot of those were not my time period. I was actually in a different country. I was in Italy back then. And so in the 80s, Nintendo really wasn't in Italy back then. So here we go. Next is Galaga, another classic arcade game that was ported to the NES and is one of my favorite classic titles. So here we go, Galaga, very cool game to pick up in the box. We have Kirby's Adventure. This one is a fantastic NES game. It is probably one of my top three or four favorite games. I actually picked this one up from Goodwill in a lot of games back in the day, and this was in there. I was so thrilled. It is complete. This one is actually pretty heavy as well. It has everything in there. And then, of course, we have one of the most classic NES games of all time as well, is The Legend of Zelda, the original, the OG copy. This one has you can see the gold cartridge inside there, so it does have a hole in the box intentionally from Nintendo. The back has a little bit of damage, a little bit of a rip, but I did get this from Goodwill back in the day in the same lot as the Kirby's Adventure. And absolutely love this game. It is a very pristine copy of the game, and I am so glad I was able to pick that up when I did. Next is Qbert, another great puzzle game, puzzle slash platform game on the NES. And obviously this is a really cool arcade game back in the day, and I very much enjoyed playing this, and so I'm happy to have the NES version of this. Alright, moving on, we have Roger Clemens MVP Baseball. This was kind of a filler title that I got in that lot of NES games from Goodwill. So happy to have it still, because it is hard to get NES games in the box, especially in nice condition. Another one we got in that lot was Donkey Kong Classics. Another one that I was like, oh man, this one is definitely worth a lot of money and is in pristine condition at this point. So this one has Donkey Kong, it has Donkey Kong Jr., both of those are on this cartridge. So actually really cool to have two games in one on this one, and it's in pristine condition, very nice, in the protector. A game we just picked up a week or two ago now is Tetris. So we've had the cartridge, but we picked up the box now. So now we have a nice copy of Tetris. One of our favorite puzzle games of all time, of course, is Tetris. So very happy to have that pretty much in the box now. Another game we got at Goodwill and that lot of games is golf with Mario on the cover there. This is a pretty decent little black box title for the NES. It is very simple, but happy to have it, and it's a fun game to play. Mickey's Mousecapade, another Capcom title right here. So I do enjoy most of the Capcom games on the NES. They are pretty fantastic for the most part, so happy to have Mickey Mousecapade on there. All right, another great puzzle game, Yoshi's Cookie. This one is another one we picked up from Goodwill. And this one, you play as like Chef Mario, and he's like in the factory, kind of, you're moving the levers and matching the shapes. It is a very cutesy puzzle game for the NES starring Yoshi. And it's a good one. I would say pick it up. If you see it for cheap, pick it up. Another awesome title. I actually got this Mega Man 4 a long time ago in a lot of Nintendo games, just all cartridges, and I upgraded it recently to boxed, and so I'm just missing the manual for all my Mega Man games, but very happy to have this Mega Man 4 box at this point. It looks pretty good and displays really well. It just has a little sticker on there. Other than that, it looks very good for its age. Alright, game that a lot of people love back in the day is WrestleMania. And of course, this has Hulk Hogan on the front here, ripping his shirt off. And it's a game I have not played yet. I am not really into wrestling, but this came in that lot of Goodwill games. So very happy to have that still. Millipede, another great game by Hall, which is the makers of Smash Brothers. A game I absolutely love playing as an arcade game back in the day, and to have this on the NES is actually really cool. Let me know what is your favorite arcade game that was ported to the NES. There were a lot. Alright, so next is Blades of Steel. This is another one we got from Goodwill. I think I might have just tested this once. It's supposed to be a pretty solid ice hockey game, and I'm happy to have it. Actually, really cool cover art. I do actually love the cover art quite a bit in this game. And from what I've heard, it's a pretty good game. Alright, so now some filler titles. Not great, but, you know, still happy to have them. We have MTV's Remote Control. Another game I got in the Goodwill lot. Most of the games I have in the box are actually from that Goodwill lot. MTV's Remote Control is a game show from the 80s. Pretty cool to have that still. Not super expensive or anything like that, but kind of cool to have. The NES Cleaning Kit, that is good to have, and it's kind of cool to see this in the box. You don't see this very often. And last but not least, we have Jeopardy, another game show one. So that rounds out all the boxed games for the NES. Let me know which one is your favorite out of those, and we're going to move on to the cartridges. Okay, here comes a metric load of cartridges. Let's go right through some of the best ones. This is probably going to be a two-part video just because of how many there are here. So we got Gauntlet. This is the 10-gen version of Gauntlet. Next, we have one of my favorite NES games, probably in the top 10, Star Tropics. This one is a lot like Zelda. Really, really cool. One of the first NES cartridges I obtained in the collection. Next, we have Adventure Island 2. Fantastic platformer for the NES. Just absolutely great. We have DuckTales. I got this from a convention quite a while ago now, maybe 5-6 years ago. One of my favorite as well. Just absolutely love DuckTales. The music is great. Great platformer for Capcom. Just fantastic. A gift from Lulu, my wife. Joust actually does have the manual as well, and is actually a really fun arcade style game on the NES. Next we have Ghost and Goblins. This one, of course, is notoriously very difficult, since you do have to play it a few times through, and just brutally hard. Fun game to play still, just for a few minutes. just to see how much you're going to get destroyed playing it. All right, another great, fantastic game for the NES, Battletoads with the manual. Great game. Love playing the arcade beat-em-ups. And, of course, this is a classic if you have the NES. Have to get this game. So fantastic. Another game that everybody has who's a Nintendo collector is Chip 'n Dale. The second one is super rare. The first one is not very expensive. But we do have it with the manual as well. It is a classic. Another great Capcom game. Highly recommend Chip 'n Dale Rescue Rangers for the NES. We have the original Mega Man game, where he's using a gun instead of his Mega Buster arm. And he looks like a 40-year-old guy, not a boy. Just the weirdest cover art you'll ever see on a game. Of course, had to have that one. Very controversial title. Alright, so now we got Zelda 2 Adventures of Link Gold cartridge. This one is not in the greatest shape, but it's actually not bad for what it is. So still happy to have that one in the collection. And then we have the gray cart variant version of Zelda 2 Adventures of Link. So there's obviously two different releases of that game. Alright, we have a shooter, a shmup, Star Soldier, pretty good, solid title. We have Strider, another great Capcom game on the NES. Next we have a Mario Brothers, just the original version, with the manual. It's actually a Duck Hunt Mario Brothers manual. So that is right there with a really nostalgic looking Funko Land sleeve. Always cool to have that in there. Next we have Taito's Renegade, another beat-em-up. We have the silver version of Metroid for the NES. And we also have the gold label version, which is kind of cool, especially because that one comes with the manual. Really cool yellow manual. I am just now missing the box for the NES Metroid. I'm probably going to try to get two different boxes to put both of these games in there. But, you know, of course, it's going to take time to find those. We have Back to the Future. Super C. Fantastic shoot 'em up game on the NES. And, of course, the original Contra. Gotta have this game. This is in the top 10 for sure of best NES games of all time. Bomberman, the original one. The second one is quite rare. I do not own that one, but at least I have the first one, and it's actually very good. Of course, top 5 for me as well is Super Mario Bros. 2. We do have a nice pristine manual for it. And this sleeve actually has a cool feature. It has a sticker of Mario with a $6 in savings sticker on it. Kind of odd, but it actually kind of adds a little flavor to this cartridge or the sleeve. Alright, so next we have Ice Climbers. This one I ended up getting in a lot with a NES from Goodwill. It's actually really fantastic to play this game. I do enjoy it quite a bit. We have kind of a sun-faded cartridge, Uncanny X-Men. I got this for very cheap back in the day. Next, we have Donkey Kong 3. Very solid platform game on the NES. And we have the other one boxed, so we also have Batman. This one just loose, but yeah, I'm looking for a box for that one. Batman, fantastic platformer on the NES. Highly recommend this one. Super fun to play. Smash TV, another kind of twin joystick shooter, but this one is obviously a little more simple. I do have the Super Nintendo version of that as well. The sequel to Star Tropics, Zoda's Revenge, Star Tropics 2. Haven't really played this one a lot, but I love the first one. I'm going to go back and play Zoda's Revenge at some point. All right, then we have King's Knight. This one is made by Square. Before it was Square Enix. Pretty cool title. Kind of a little bit of a hidden gem. Check it out if you get a chance. Kind of tough game, as most of the NES ones are. Kid Icarus. Of course, very classic game. Probably in the top 25 NES games of all time. Just very awesome platform game. Fun to play. We have, of course, Excitebike. Another classic, gotta have it for the collection. Duck Hunt by itself, just Duck Hunt, not with anything else. We have the original Mario Brothers arcade game for the NES. This one is super fun to play, and just love it. Super fun. They made another version of this on the Virtual Boy called Mario Clash. It's basically based off this arcade game, but in 3D. We have the combo cart with all three games of Mario Brothers, Duck Hunt, and World Class Track Meet. That is pretty cool to have in the collection as a variant. We do have a nice crispy manual here. Very, very nice. Yeah. So, lots of great games so far. Hope you guys are enjoying looking at the collection so far. We have another Mario Brothers Duck Hunt. This one has the manual as well. Gotta have all those Mario Brothers games. Okay, next one is Konami's Stinger. This one is quite weird. Another shoot 'em up game. I've only played this a few times. I think it's pretty cool though. We have a game that really intrigued me for a while, which is Adventures of Dino Ricky. Just very, very strange game. Take a look when you guys get a chance. I think it's a like over the top, actually side-scrolling shooter kind of. Yeah, it's a weird one. Check it out when you get a chance if you're interested in that one. It's a very good game. Next is Ninja Gaiden. Very cool game, very good platformer. And it has three different games total on the NES. Here's the second one. Ninja Gaiden 2, The Dark Sword of Chaos. Really cool Funko Land sleeve that came with. Yeah, this is a good one as well. If you know me, you know I love my RPGs, and of course I have to have Final Fantasy, so I have the original one on the NES, of course. If you know me, you know I collect all those RPGs. River City Ransom, this is a game that commands quite a... It's definitely not a cheap game anymore, and so I was like, you know what, I love these kinds of games, and I needed to have this in the collection, so I was like, grab it. A very underrated shmup, Life Force. Great game. Super fun to play. It's another Konami title. Feels a little bit like a Contra game, but it's a shmup. We have the original Double Dragon game. Pretty awesome. I do prefer, I think, the second one. The original Ninja Turtles game. Gotta have this one. Obviously, I have all three of them. This one is the most frustrating out of all of them. We have Dracula's Curse, Castlevania 3. This one, I think, is the most expensive out of the three, as far as I remember. Pretty good game. We have Gradius, another great shmup on the NES. Fun to play. Mega Man 6, very sought-after title. This is when they started getting the box or the cartridge art right, and it looks really nice. Looks very cartoony the way it should. This is kind of the way that Mega Man 1 should have looked on the NES. But as you can tell, this is released quite a bit later. I think almost into the 90s at this point. So now we have another classic, Wrecking Crew. This is one where Mario is basically a construction worker destroying stuff. Fun game. NES Open, a golf game featuring Mario as well. Love this game, super fun to play. Alright, then we have another rare game. Rare as in like the publisher, not scarcity wise. Snake Rattle and Roll, super fun to play. We have RoboCop, this one's super fun as well. We have The Adventures of Lolo by the makers of Kirby, HAL Laboratories. It's a good one. I only own the first one. I am looking for the second and third one as well for the collection. What NES collection wouldn't be complete without Mike Tyson's Punch-Out? This one, of course, is a banger. It is one of the most notoriously awesome NES games you've ever played. You have Dragon Warrior. Before it was called Dragon Quest, it's called Dragon Warrior in the US. It wasn't until they brought the seventh game. Actually, that one was also called Dragon Warrior 7. So I think at some point they changed it over to Dragon Quest. We have Yoshi, another puzzle game, fun to play. Double Dragon 2, this is the Revenge. fantastic beat-em-up. If you enjoy NES beat-em-ups, get that one. We have Legend of the Kage. I don't quite remember this one too well. I have to go back and play this one. Million Secret Castle, a one I picked up at a flea market quite a while ago. We have Turtles 2, the arcade game. Fantastic game. I cannot seem to do very well in this game. I can beat Turtles 4, Turtles in Time, just fine. This one seems to be very difficult for me, for whatever reason. Then we have a game I do enjoy quite a bit, which is Turtles 3, the Manhattan Project. This one is fun to play, two players. It's a lot more fair in terms of... compared with Turtles 2, Turtles 3, Manhattan Project is a lot more fun to play than two players. I think it was released quite a bit later, and it just feels a lot more solid and fair and balanced. So I'd say if you want to pick up one of the Turtles games, pick up this one. It is, I think, a little more expensive, but it's definitely worth it. We have Double Dragon 3. This one I did not like very much, but it had to have it for the collection, of course. And last but not least, we have Bionic Commando, a game that I love on the Xbox 360 and PS3. This one is really, really fun with the Bionic arm and everything like that. So this will be part one of the NES collection. Stay tuned for part two. That one I'm going to show off the consoles, the accessories, and the lesser titles up on the shelf over there. Thank you so much for watching. If you watched all the way to the end, thank you so much. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button when you get a chance. It helps the channel grow and you'll see more of our videos. Alright, hope you guys catch the next one, and thank you so much. Bye.